Well, yeah, that's alright, we're only just over.
Okay, that's all your fault.
No, I asked you to do it early and you didn't bother, so... You told me you'd done it, you sent me a message saying done. When I went to the toilet, you just told Porky.
No, I didn't. I said I was going to sleep and I told you 1 hour ago.
Is this a race going on here?
Oh, Max Miller.
It is. It's Marius Burt. Behind Matt. Ooh. We got a race.
For the lead. Not for the lead. It's for third.
Oh,
he's looking the inside and boom, he fell asleep.
This could be quite interesting because we know that Mr. Marius Burt won't hang about. And they're only 34 seconds off of second place here. I'd be surprised if we don't see Mr. Bertie Boy coming up the field again.
Well, he's trying for sure.
Well, they've completed 175 laps.
I only completed one. Nearly.
You ain't done anything.
I did. And my mind.
Well, if it was that simple, we'd all be doing it.
And I still don't know the track.
Oh, what, you don't know Silverstone?
I do know, but I don't know the corner names and stuff. I can't keep them in my head. Oh, no. I gotta take a power nap.
Oh, hang on. There we go. This is about second now. There's someone's changed position. So what we'll do, we'll go with this one. Which is still. No, what's that one? Oh, for God's sake. Camera's in this thing is terrible, man.
Yeah, it's the click, it's green.
It's the tree I wanted. There we go, and then... it's that button, isn't it? Is it? It's one of these buttons. Do something. What the hell, man?
Oh, you're such a professional cameraman.
No, it's just wireless bloody keyboard pile of crap.
What do you want?
On board. I think my batteries have died in my keyboard. Yeah, go on board.
Okay. Give me 1 second.
The wonders of technology. There we go.
I'm love it. I don't care.
Sure, I don't start singing all over the old nightmares. RSI Gaming 1 then,
it's it sounds like shame. Those people singing. Oh god. Okay, quick power nap or I'm dead.
Yeah, this is the year right when became world champion in 2002.
Yeah. Well, Alonso and Hamilton 1 point behind, I guess.
Mm-hmm. So much faster. Okay, fuck this one. Chuckle vision, didn't I?
What? My chuckle mic fell.
I told you it might be chuckle vision. Chuckle vision, chuckle, chuckle vision.
Oh god.
Wake up, man.
I can't. Oh,
49 minutes to go.
Sure, the time is moving.
Isn't it?
It moved like five minutes.
There's something going on with the time. Every time I look, it's like 2 minutes we've gone. It's bollocks.
That's because you're tired and keep watching.
It is. It's all they say, isn't it? A clock watch goes slower or whatever they're saying.
Yep.
Or watch clock goes slower. Or whatever way around it is.
For the 24 hours, I want to do like 2 stents or something. You know, 2 hours talking, 2 hours sleeping.
No, yeah. I'm sure, oh, no. Gosh.
There you go. Oh, let's. Yeah. Why are you laughing now?
A blonde and a brunette were walking in the park. Oh look, a dead bird, said the brunette. The blonde looked up.
God, I'm hanging myself up on my headset. Oh no, this is not good. I'm not suffocating myself.
You're what, masturbating yourself?
No! What the fuck, dude? No. I said... Oh my god.
It sounded this to is... me like you said self-masturbating.
No! I was saying I'm self-suffocating myself.
No, self-suffocating.
Yeah, with my
If you didn't have a war engine, I'd be able to understand you.
Sorry, I'm eating.
You're eating again.
Yeah, biscuits.
What, biscuits? Oh, you can't beat a biscuit.
It's called the biscuits of your dreams.
The biscuits of your dreams?
Yeah.
The biscuits of my dreams can turn the winning lottery numbers.
Well, to get the biscuit of my dreams, I have to sleep, else I won't have it. So, if it's a biscuit, I will sleep because it's food. Oh my gosh.
That was me doing it with my mouth.
Oh yeah. I thought it was me. I was like, where is the heat? I can't feel anything. God damn it. I have to retry.
I'm sorry for that bloody funny.
What? What is funny?
Hang on, I'll post it. Oh, I just got sent me. Oh dear.
Question. Yeah. How can that be a question? When? Oh, when do you kick a midget in the titties? Oh my god, what the hell? Oh god, gosh.
That's brilliant, I love it. Oh, that's a blinding joke, that is. Well, I had to think about it at first. I thought, well, I don't thingy it, and then I'll twig. Oh dear. You got any battles going on anywhere?
Yeah, here.
Yeah, you're keeping you away. Oh, there's a battle. Marius Burt is only 5 tenths behind the leader.
I already put it in. No, I already put it in.
Oh, but he didn't.
I put 7 and you put 3. So I gotta have my Daytona cameras.
Come on, Mr. Burks. Yeah. I do believe that three wide are going to win this one. And you think they got disconnected earlier, now they're coming back for the lead.
It's just me or are there eyes on that car?
That's it, he's done it.
Not yet, not yet. Oh, they touch!
Oh dear, dear. That was a bit eager beaver.
And they touch again. And...
oh, and we've got a car in the pit. Onlinemotorsport.com.
And he has a run, he's coming again, he's coming from the inside. No, he's not. He has to step out of it.
Yeah, he's pulled away now. He should have waited. He's got in the slipstream again now. Harry fought a lot of exit speed, didn't he?
Yeah, he's jumping in the pits.
And they pitted. I wonder if he'll change over to Carsten now. He shouldn't, because I think he's only just got in the car that last stint, so... I think most drivers are doing 2 or 3 stints. Oh, I'm all about what's going on anyway. Nope.
Okay, be right back. I have to eat. I can't sleep like this. I have to eat, really.
You can't sleep alright, because you need to eat.
Yeah. I can't sleep on an empty stomach.
Okay then.
Okay.
You're not supposed to be sleeping.
Yeah, but oh gosh. Well, being hungry is more annoying than being tired. So
no, this is true.
Be right back.
Thank you.
RML Racing Team 3 are in the pits. Ronnie Hannell's now in the lead. They're one pit stop behind, so that'll change again.
after electrocuting myself a few times, I'm full on back of energy.
How the hell did you electrocute yourself?
So I could stay awake.
Okie dokie. Yep, definitely need a straitjacket.
A what? A straitjacket?
Mm-hmm.
What's that for?
A straitjacket and a padded cell.
Oh. So, what did I miss?
Nothing.
Okay.
Absolutely sod all.
Nothing going
on. Hang on a minute. Witchwood Court disconnected. Oh,
you crashed.
I'm so have we. Oh, see, look, as soon as you come back, it's broke.
No, if somebody, I just saw if somebody disconnects, we disconnect also.
Yeah. Right, just come up. Which would call.
Awesome.
No rejoins caused us to get kicked off.
Oh god, what are my cigarettes? Oh god, I'm... Oh my god, I'm almost out of my pack again.
Yeah?
I'm already out of my pack almost.
Almost out of your packet?
Yeah, a pack of cigarettes.
Oh, stop smoking them then.
I wish. I just don't have the strength, I guess. What the fuck is up with this TV?
There we go, we're back.
My volume keeps going up and stuff. Wait, what? Question.
No, maybe.
What's long and hard and has... Oh gosh. I didn't even see that one before. That's a good one. I'm gonna ask that one soon to my girlfriend. To see what she says. She will probably misunderstand, but oh well. Oh yeah, I didn't check Facebook in a while. Oh no. What the hell is this?
Down to 5 hours and 14 minutes remaining. The track temperature is 20.8 degrees. We've completed 195 laps, and your top 10 are All Star Racing Team 2, Free Wide Motorsport, Independent Sim Racer, RSR Gaming Team 1, X Factor Racing Team 1, RML Racing Team 1, X Factor Racing Team 3, Independent Sim Racer GT 3. Yeah. And Will Graver just jumped to 9th. And GP Racing, no, they're tossing between the two. It's Witchwood's climbing up again after their disconnect. Messing up the timing a bit. I'll give it a couple of laps to settle in. See where that ends up taking us. Any on-screen battles? No.
I don't think there's any battles virtual going on.
That is one you can ask your girlfriend.
It's gonna be something I don't wanna know. Should I read it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I don't even have to ask the question. If I refuse, I just get dragged away.
Oh, He's definitely one you could tell her.
This so fits me. Perfect.
Yeah, I know this was thinking when I read it. Right, where should we do Redoubry? There, we haven't visited that one. Go there. Hang on, that's not right. Let's try that again.
What's up with everyone trying to sell their iPhones? If you ask them, why are they selling your iPhone, it's like, oh yeah, it's like 2 weeks old or so. And why the hell would you buy an iPhone?
Oh, what's happening with my buttons again? Oh, for God's sake. Oh, that button's working. So why aren't the rest of it? Oh. Go on board. Select the on board.
Okay.
For some reason, I can pick the car, but it's not letting me control the numbers over the map for some bizarre reason. What's the thing?
Okay, we're on board.
There we go, good one.
Yeah. Yeah, sometimes you have to click the bar above. Sometimes it turns to grey when you change your car. And then you can change the view. I don't know why it's doing that, but...
And there's you, so you can...
Yeah, there's something wrong with it.
Yeah, they use it.
Well, you're talking about yourself, then.
Well, why not? Yeah, well, at least you've got one thing, I'm on it.
Well, Mr. Colin there is really close onto that Lamborghini. Probably a back marker, but...
He didn't leave him much room, did he? That mark, well, we just slammed straight into the side.
He's thinking the same.
And even I'm going to have to change my pants off of that one.
All-star racing has a comfortable lead at the moment. On
what? Like hard indeed.
If I have to put my money on any of them for the last 5 hours, it's still 5 hours, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh goddamn, why does it sound so long? Well, I would put my money on Tree Wide. I think they can still win.
Yeah, I'm also gonna think about the Independent Sim Racer GT2 and all still within contention. Well, Rocket Ronnie and Sebastian.
Yeah, they're only 4 seconds off. Four seconds around of Marius. But still, after the little issue they had, they were like flying through the field again, just taking that position back. Yeah, that's why I think 25 seconds. I think it's still doable.
Mm-hmm.
If they don't experience any issues, if it comes to pure racing, I think they can do it.
There's one for sure.
Although the last lap was 2/10 of the pace of the All-Star Racing team. Yeah, and now they did a 1/2 second off of the pace. Also, Independence just did it 2:01.6. Nearly about a sec. They had a second out of Tree Wide. So yeah, Ronnie is still in contention.
What are you watching?
I'm not watching. I didn't click anything. I'm just checking the live timings. And yeah, they're bringing the gap down. So I'm gonna take over the cameras and ouch, go to Mr. Rocket Ronnie, who's in pursuit of Marius.
While you're doing that, I'm gonna have a sleep.
Okay. I don't think there's any close battle. Oh, actually there is.
Yeah, there's 12.
Yeah.
12 close battles going on.
There we go. Mr. Michael Kahlenberg is just 1.5 seconds of Daniel Schutt for RML Racing. So we're gonna switch to, here we go. No, that's not right. There we go. No. Why are you not listening? Ah, here we go. Badass cameras don't want to listen to me.
Told you, not the camera, it's the user.
There we go. He's not that far behind.
No, well, here we go with our Daytona win. Really fancy a KFC or a McDonald's right now, and neither of them deliver.
Oh, the gap's down to just under 1 second.
Now ain't that just a kick in the bum? Nice KFC bargain bucket, man. Oh, or a boneless banquet. Oh, don't scroll.
None
of
these places don't deliver it on your head. Food again. Why are you so evil?
No, I haven't had nothing to eat now. It was 3:30 or I lost it. That's when I had them noodles.
No, it wasn't. It was like 4
o'clock. Well, no, it was about 4
so.
O'clock.
Yeah, and you eat
yeah,
noodles.
Yeah, but that's the time difference. See, over here it was 3:30.
Oh god, why am I getting low frame rate again?
No, I'm on 15, well 15 to 16 fluctuates between the two. It's Shane, man, he's hacked your computer, I'm telling you. That's what he's done. He's hacked it, and he's gonna do you.
Whoa, what? Oh, that's my phone.
Well, that'll be the wife.
Yeah, I suppose so.
Don't sound so happy, are you?
Nah, it's just a neighbour.
Probably asking where his sandwiches are from last night.
You can bake me bloody new ones.
You're the sandwich maker.
Yeah, I just only meet him once.
Ooh, we're up to 6 viewers, come on!
Oh, we're so popular. High.
Did you see that message?
I bet he came for me.
It's for Shane.
Oh, no, I didn't read it yet. Let me check. Oh no. Oh gosh. Yeah, that's definitely for Shane. I should tell Adam. You're doing it wrong, dude. Do you know what I saw?
Well, no.
You probably didn't see it yet, but that's because you're yourself. But it's like... No, I'm like serious, you know, or maybe I'm just hallucinating, I don't know. Wait, I have to check to be sure first before I make an epic fail out of myself.
No, I'll do that all the time, I wouldn't worry.
No, but...
competition stiff.
I don't know who's... You know the orange Ferrari?
Yeah.
The 458. No, the 458. You said it looks nice.
Yeah.
Wait. Okay, yeah, it's just me again. I was gonna say the one we're watching right now and the orange kind of look the same, just different color scheme. But yeah, it's the same team.
Oh, I didn't geez, I'm going on.
Notice. Well, that's maybe because I'm watching in 2 frames per second that I didn't notice.
No, I'm getting brilliant frames per second, mate. I'm on 15, 17, 9, 17, 15. I wonder if it will jump to 20 again at any point in the future.
Well, it looks like Daniel is keeping the gap. I'm screwing myself right now.
No. Do you want a minute on your own? You know, I'll give you a minute to yourself if you want.
Oh god. Oh my, are you really kidding me? Are they selecting Justin Bieber for best pop music? Oh my god.
Well, they're doing what?
Yeah, best pop music. They selected Justin Bieber.
You're having a laugh. Okay, now that's
and
an epic fail I've ever seen.
The prize goes to... Oh my god, One Direction. Are you kidding me?
Oh, well, it's just as bad. Okay, now...
Oh, and I have another message. Now it's the wife. I'm almost home. I'm in your street. Oh.
She can't come round yet. We've got another 4 hours to go. 5 hours to go.
I know.
She left the wife. Have you got any washing up she can be doing for the next 5 hours?
Well, yeah, and some dishes.
Well, if you give her a toothbrush and tell her you want the kitchen floor mopped with that, that's bound to keep her busy for 5 hours.
And when you're done, start with my room, and then do the stairs.
Yeah, that's it, yeah, you know. Make it entertaining, they can give her some challenges, like shred some chewing gum and stuff into it. Make it exciting for her.
That was a very subtle text message. Well...
4 hours and 58 minutes remaining.
Oh yeah.
Dee-dee-doo.
That's a true story. Oh my god, are you seriously gonna give me a live action from One Direction?
I still wanna watch it.
I still wanna smash my TV.
No, change the channel.
they steal songs that ABBA has made.
Haven't you only got like bloody one station or something on your TV?
No, but I just put it on music channel.
You might as well put it on something girly because she's bound to when she gets there.
Oh no, it's the Bandits. I don't even know them. No, they're singing a song from Netsky. What the hell? Yeah, that's totally wrong.
Oh. Oh, that's a brilliant film, that is. The Amazing Spider-Man, that's cool.
Yes, I had already.
Oh, yep, that's wicked.
Yeah, not bad. I didn't see the other ones before, though, so...
I'll see them all. The newer one's a better one than a lot, in my opinion.
Well, and Ronnie is battling with Marius for second position, and he's right behind it. Ronnie is absolutely, again, being Rocket Ronnie, he's flying. He closed the gap of 3.5 seconds it was a few laps ago. Oh, I thought he was going wide, but...
Yeah, I thought he was going off then and all.
Yeah,
ready. We're probably going to get a server crash in a minute.
As soon as he overtakes, bam, server gone. Nah, I don't want server gone, so I have to commentate even more longer then.
Yep.
And I still have to go to the shop. Oh, God, me.
Yeah, you can send your girlfriend.
Nah, she said it's cold outside, so...
Yeah, but she's already out. Just text her and say, get me this on the way here. Well, she's already got to go out to get to yours, just tell her to get it on the way.
Nah, she lives next to me anyway, so...
She lives next door to you?
Yeah.
Yeah, is she the one you make the sandwiches for?
No, I made them for myself.
Is this the next door neighbour that you make food for, and then they make food for you?
No. I wish.
I'll see. So you got two fucking next door neighbours that want a bit, huh? And they don't put your eggs in one basket, a lot of the style. keep one in reserve, eh?
Nah, you always have to do that. Yeah, I think Mary's started to struggle a bit, but... Yeah, the gap still staying around the same between Michael and Marius. Although Michael did a 2:03 last lap, with Marius doing a 2:02.7, and Ronnie matched that lap, obviously because he's behind.
Well, Nico Rosberg's out.
So, we've seen great overtakes already before from Ronnie, so I think this will be a good one. He's in the slipstream. He's getting closer, but not close enough. He's moving
to the inside.
He's got it. He's in the inside. Oh, Marius had him let him go. He's through his tires. Yeah, Marius is through his tires.
Wouldn't surprise me if Marius is due to pit in sometime in a minute.
He keeps going. He's going for another lap. He's not giving up yet. He thinks it's still possible. But Ronnie is now up in P2. Oh, and Michael Ryder, who was leading the race, has actually pitted. So, Ronnie is now leading the race. The blooper of the year. Lance Armstrong, the Fira train. What the hell? I bet the train's gonna win. Oh, it didn't. Thank you. God, oh God. Well, we just saw Schindberg replying.
Oh, he was solid, is he?
Facebook, and he said, oh God, with a lot of dots. Oh God, oh God, oh God. Oh, beautiful song. Passenger gonna win for sure. Well, also looks Andrea Schmidt took over from the All-Star Racing Team Fucar.
We're up to 7 viewers.
Well, that's one extra.
Getting gooned. It's probably Shane.
Hello, Shane. Nice to for you to tune in. Kinda late, but yeah, want to jump in and say hello?
Hello.
Maybe we can get a 4 hour of sleep or something.
Yeah, Shane, come on in, you come, son. Me and Dimitri are falling asleep, you can come and do the riff. Yeah, well, he says he can't speak, but there's nothing to say, he can't use sign language. And he puts his webcam on. Oh, stretching time. Oh. Are the battles going on? Let's have a look. Vilchel. Closest one at the moment there.
Maximilian is on P4. He's only 3 seconds behind Andrea Schmidt for P3.
Oh, that Q-bits are off, is it?
And who else do we have in contention for an upcoming battle? Doesn't look like anyone. There's 2 cars in the pits. 124 LSF Racer is in the pit. And 186, the RML Racing Team 2 with Daniel Schwitz. He's also in the pit. We also have the Fahrermannschaft Racing Car.
That's
Marcus Meuler. He's also in the pit. Then Andy Penson, Sim Racer GT1, Andreas Rosek has disconnected. Yeah, that's been a long time ago. I thought it was a pit stop. So we have only 3 cars that has a DNF. And that's Lazy Man Racing on the beginning of the race on lap 41. And then we have the oh-so-famous broadcast team with special driver Wayne Reed, who decided to disconnect on 111 laps.
It was a joint decision between the two of us. The cars too. Utter rubbish.
I'm always wondering on the live things, what's the blue thing with the 1 on it?
Aye?
There's a column, and it says 1 and a blue square.
The old blue flags.
Yeah.
If they get shown 3 blue flags at the same time, then they get a drive-through penalty. Like they're showing 2, and then that one's 1.
I can see flat spot racing, 2 blue flags.
Yep. It's gone back down to 1, so it's all good. But yeah, that's for the spotters more than anything. Thank you.
Why the hell is this poking me? Oh my gosh, Shane. Wayne. See, it's always Shane, because he always used to do that. Gosh.
Diddly doo. Diddly there is, Mr. Hacker.
Come on, any close battles? It was a nice race so far, a lot of action, but I think stuff is settling down at the moment. Don't see.
You changed your description.
What?
How did you change your description?
My God, I didn't. Wayne says he sucked. No, I can't say that on TV, can I? God, cost me my job.
Well, you've been sacked 6 times, and we've got a pit stop going on.
Yes, GP
racing, team.
That sounds like the Lamborghini.
Yeah, it'll be a message to British. Oh, there's a surprise. Come on.
Oh, come on, Wayne.
Not me this time. Whatever.
Nah, it's not. It's never you.
I'm on Facebook.
Yeah, I'm trying to talk to someone.
Oh, hang on. We've got, Marius Burt is in the pit. And so is Will Witchwood. No, no, it's not, mate. I'm completely innocent in whatever's going on. Thank you. We've got VE racing rifle.
Whoop, 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 whoop on Gundam Star.
Are you serious? He wins a Grammy. Oh my god. He made one song and he wins a Grammy. I don't even understand what he's singing about.
We're down to 5 viewers again. 5 viewers. What have we got? 4 hours and 39 minutes to go. What's the track temp? 19.9 and 211 laps completed. Sorry, we need to talk in there much, but there's never much to talk about.
Yeah, and there's not currently any close battles going on also.
I'm still
we
waiting.
You can only watch the sexy orange.
What time are you sending me them pictures of your girlfriend?
What? No, you're a dirty minded guy.
It's a pity you're wearing headset, because I was going to wait for her to turn up and ask about it. Then I was going to say, yeah, when are you sending them pictures you told me about? Oh, we've got a pit stop going on. X Factor 1 Racing. Maximilian. There's just not a lot happening. There's no battles anywhere. Closest one at the minute is there. I talked to N too fast, but not done it. No, what's going on? What the hell?
Okay, so we got Maximilian entering the pits on position 4 for GRLXF Racing 1. He has come in to make his 8th pit stop.
This is the closest battle. But not by mega close, and he's got 2.5 seconds in it. So this is the closest battle then. What can we talk about?
Let's talk about the light bulbs and the lights.
Talk about what?
The light bulbs and the headlights. Dunno.
Oh yeah, great topic.
Now,
off you go then, you start then and I'll join in.
I don't know what to say about lights, I only know Xenon 400Ks or so, whatever it is.
What about the F1, what's your prediction for the winner tomorrow?
Oh, that's such a hard call to make already.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know, Malaysia's kind of a fascinating, fun track to drive, but yeah. They could be struggling a lot, like we saw Red Bull being slower in Q2. They were like only getting, wait, first 11 place on 15 place, I mean in Q1. And then in Q2 they did a little bit better. And then with the sudden rain they got like both top spots. So I think they just beat the car already on for a rain setup.
Yeah, see, I'm thinking possibly either Hamilton or Alonso. I don't think Raikkonen can do it now because he's starting 10th instead of 7th. It was a big ask from 7th, but then he started 7th in Melbourne, so never say never with Raikkonen, but it's a bloody long shot. Going by the practice sessions and quali, Lewis was like second quickest quite a lot, and we know Alonso has mega quick race pace generally as a rule of thumb, so, and like you say, both the Red Bulls were struggling in the dry, so...
Yeah, Ferrari's actually improved quite a lot over last year, if you can see what Felipe is doing right now. Uh-huh. I think he did out-qualify his teammate again.
Yep.
By a 10, but still, it's out-qualifying, if you saw his pace from last year. So, I think for the Constructors' Championship that Ferrari has a bigger advantage than the likes, like McLaren. I don't think McLaren will do anything this season. I think Mercedes will be even higher in the constructor style than McLaren will. But we don't know that for sure, but like Mercedes is right now, they are doing real great with a car that's not that good. And it has to be said, they all thought Hamilton would be like super quick over Nico Rosberg, but Rosberg has shown that he's not afraid to put the pedal to the metal and try to out-qualify his teammate.
Yeah. So I think there's going to be a few drivers that are going to throw out a few surprises tomorrow. The only thing...
Yeah.
I think Massa will struggle with Alonso purely and simply because generally Alonso's first two or three laps... Eh? No, I don't think it'll be team orders. I think it'll be too early in the season for team orders because there's nothing to say that Alonso is in contention, but...
Yeah, but
I think the problem is Alonso at the start of every race he's ever been at, he's always quicker than Massa at the starts, like, not off the line, but he gains more positions quickly. You know, it's always been Alonso's strongest point, you know, for many seasons. He's always been, wherever he's qualified, by the end of lap three, he's normally pretty much gained a good cut of a position, whereas Massa never seems to. He tends, if anything, he falls back. So, I think that'll be a good battle to be watching.
Yeah, but I think if Felipe can get a greater start out of Alonso, that he will, they won't even ask him anymore. He's just gonna lift the throttle up, let Alonso pass, and just defend from Webber or so.
Yeah, not this time of the season. It won't be too early on yet. Because anything can happen. It's only, you know, second race. There's nothing to gain for Alonso doing it. I mean, at the end of the day, they'll be careful. I mean, if Alonso's a hell of a lot quicker than Massa, then yeah, but that's more point of the fact is that if he's faster anyway, he's well saving wiping each other out, just letting bloody pass. But I can't see it being this early in the season that Ferrari will already be asking Massa to move over. Because there's just no point, because there's nothing to say that Massa wouldn't beat Alonso in the championship. You know, it's
he can
only
if
race
he just
two.
Has a chance.
There's another, you know, 16 to go, including tomorrow. So, well, no, 18, isn't it, tomorrow? So, you know, it's a long season. I certainly wouldn't be. If I was Ferrari, I wouldn't be asking anything of Massa to that degree just yet. But see, Rosberg, he's been pretty quick in the dry as well.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. The Mercedes is, we know. It eats tires. We saw Melbourne with Hamilton trying to follow a strategy, and he had to go quicker, and he was like instantly, if I have to go quicker, the strategy is going to falter.
Yep.
Yeah, he was right. He knew the tires would go just burn to hell. So we know that there are actually even more pace in a Mercedes, an actual race pace, but... Yeah, they still have to figure something out to make the tires last much longer, like the Sauber was last year. It was super easy on its tires.
Yeah, it's something same as with the Lotus. Good with its tires last year and good with its tires this year, so it's... I think that'll be Raikkonen, and what could bring him up a few places is the fact that he knows he can go a lot longer on the tires compared to others, so...
Plus, he was faster than Alonso on older tyres.
Yeah.
So that was also very interesting.
Raikkonen is faster than you.
Can you confirm you understood that message? Oh god. Well, I think we have to keep an eye on Suttle, because he hadn't been raced for a year in Formula One, and just comes back to Force India and just gets in the car and just shows everyone that he still is a worthy racer in a car that's a little bit less than, let's say, a Lotus or a Mercedes. It's just level of a Williams or a Sauber, but still he's doing some nice results. And he also got to Q3, I believe.
I don't think I've got my sound back now.
I've been talking to you and you didn't hear me.
What the heck?
Yeah, I can hear you.
That's why.
Oh, dear me.
There we go.
So I've been talking to you and you have never been replying.
The last I heard was, you said, can you confirm that message or something, right?
Oh my god, that's way far back. Yeah, I was talking about Adrian Suttle, that we have to keep an eye out for him, because he didn't race for like a whole year, and his teammate Di Resta is like 4 years now, or is it his third year?
Yeah.
I can't even remember.
Third.
I think it's his third or his fourth that he's starting now.
It's his third year.
He's a great racer also, but he has already heavily outperformed. Has been outperformed by Adrian Suttle, so we know it's possible.
Anything is possible.
I still reckon that Charles Peak would win it though. There's a big pile up in front of him, and it wipes out every single car.
I can see Jules Bianchi getting...
You can see Deadpool?
No, I can see Jules Bianchi getting, for next season, a real race seat. I mean, he performed 1.6 seconds out of pole position time.
That's I don't think that means anything, really.
Yeah, but he was 1 second faster than a Caterham. 1.4 seconds faster than his teammate. I think that's a really good result.
No, yeah, it's quick, but it certainly doesn't warrant. So the thing is, none of the top teams are taking, because it's too inexperienced. Ferrari won't touch him at the bargain, well, they won't even take Perez. Certainly he's too inexperienced, and yet Perez was a Ferrari developer driver, you know. I think the odds on favourite for Ferrari, if Webber doesn't go there, if they offer him again. I don't think Perez was a Ferrari developed driver. I think it'll be Adrian Sutil that'll go to Ferrari, and I think he deserves it more than Webber. I think Webber's just crap, he's always been crap.
Yeah,
Webber,
he's always been in the middle.
It annoys me because everyone, you know, goes in about Vettel this and Vettel that, you know, he's not that good. I mean, I don't like the bloke. Then they say, you know, he's not that brilliant and all the rest of it. But yet Mark Webber's in exactly the same car as Vettel, and he's not winning half the races. He is, so it goes to show you how crap Webber really is. You know, he's been in a world championship winning car for 3 years and he's done absolutely nothing with it. He doesn't deserve it. I don't know why Red Bull keep firing him, because he's, I think he's just taken up the seat that another driver that's about to achieve something should be there.
Yeah, that's true.
But Webber's had his day. I don't think a lot of people are very
Will
retire at the end of the season. I kind of hope he does, to be honest.
We could say that same about Felipe Massa.
I'd agree with that, but we know
that Felipe Massa and Fernando Alonso are, like, you can see it immediately, that's two different driving styles, and they always develop the car to Alonso's benefits, and that's what happened last year, and that's why Felipe Massa was struggling to find anything potential in the car, and I think he's getting it straight right now. and he has like more chance and more competitiveness. I think I can see him win one race at least.
Yeah,
that would be a nice goodbye gift, I think, for his last year. If it's his last year, maybe we'll see him next year again, I don't know. But it would be a nice motivation if he actually wins a race in a car where he hasn't taken anything yet.
You never know, maybe Ferrari will do the old switcheroo and they'll put Adrian Sutil in the Ferrari and Massa will go to Force India, which I think it'd be quite handy because Massa's got years of development experience, so it'd be good for Force India. And then obviously is Adrian a chance, I think, you know, either in the Red Bull or Ferrari to show what he can really do. I mean, it goes to show how quick he is compared to Paul Di Resta, you know, two different bloody cars, and you can't say that that's down to Paul's inexperience. He's been in Formula One for 3 years, and he was a DTM champion, so it's not like he doesn't know how to win championships and drive cars. Thing is with Formula One, you can come into it as a good driver, but you have to what it takes to keep doing it. And I think half the drivers that are in F1 now do not deserve to be where they are, and they don't. They really don't. I mean, you look at Formula One, McLaren. I don't think Jensen deserves to be there. He has his moments where he's monster quick, but it's like one race every season.
Mostly it's in more wet conditions.
Yeah, I don't think Perez deserves to be there because, yeah, he had some good results last year, but I don't think he's an outstanding driver. I don't think he's a future world champion like everyone thinks that he's going to be. I don't see it with Perez. I think he's one of these drivers that will be like what Coulthard and Eddie Irvine and all that lot were like Barrichello. You know, they'll win an odd few races here and there, and nothing else will ever come of it. And drivers like that, I think, shouldn't be in race with, you know, championship winning cars. It's people that deserve seats like that. Your Alonso, Raikkonen's, Hamilton, Hülkenberg, I think, deserves to be in a front-running car as well, because I think he's an outstanding driver. And also, as much as people don't like him, Pastor Maldonado, because, he causes a lot of accidents. But you think what he achieved last year compared to Bruno Senna. Plus, he won a race, which wasn't an easy victory. You know, he had Alonso all over him for most of the race. When he's quick, he's freaking quick, you know? And I mean, if someone took him under their wing and calmed him down like what Schumacher did with Massa, I think... I reckon Maldonado, I reckon he's definitely a championship contender in the right car.
Yeah, you got a point there, but I mean, most of teams always have to commit themselves onto a wingman where they can rely on most of the time. I was even shocked to know that Hülkenberg wanted to leave for Zintia after that strong performance on the last race of the season that he had. Was like, why would you go to a lower budget team? Well, lower budget, really, it's not that much lower, but okay. But I don't know why he didn't move. It's not like Sauber is like a better car than a Force India.
Yeah, but he'd already signed his contract earlier on in the season, but I never figured why he went there in the first place, because like everyone said, you only generally leave a team if you're going forwards. He went sideways, and the thing is, I bet he's kicking himself now, because Sauber are absolutely bloody nowhere, the same as Williams aren't. You know, the Sauber at the moment, I mean, they've only had one race, but their qualifying pace wasn't anything good either.
Sauber just has a good looking car, that's all I think about it. I always disliked Sauber, the way it looked, it was always looking like crap. But the design this year of the Sauber looks pretty decent, but it doesn't have any pace in it yet. It can still change, you know, but...
Yeah, but it's all looks
To see what Perez did last year with Sauber on Malaysia, you should expect at least like a driver like Hülkenberg, which I consider is much better than Perez.
Yep.
But now they're a wall at the back.
I think there's a few teams this year should be ashamed of what they've achieved over winning, because they've gone backwards, and I think the biggest worst of that is McLaren. Their car's a bloody joke.
Yeah, you know, I remember Hamilton saying when he left, he said to Perez that he had a championship winning car. So I don't know if he was trying to laugh at it or he was bloody serious, but if he was serious, then
they're nowhere. Slagged him off for leaving McLaren. So no, he was going backwards, going to Mercedes. But at the end of the day, there's been no proof of that, because you don't go on the last season's results, you go on this season's, and as it stands at the minute, McLaren are nowhere, Mercedes are doing really well. So it's, you know, yeah, McLaren generally redevelop their car over and over again, but it's going to be all too little too late. You know, if they're going to have a crap result this weekend, you'd pretty guarantee it. So that puts them two races already behind before they've even bloody started. It's, you know, whereas Mercedes, you know, they had a half decent result at Melbourne. They're likely to have a half decent result tomorrow. And yet, you know, Hamilton was a wally for leaving. I think he'd done the best thing he should have done. See, there's something that I think made Hamilton leave, other than the commitments, which is like he said he wanted more time himself, which I don't blame him for. Right? It's the engines. Because
also,
it's a comment that Adrian Newey said that as a 2014, because the engines are going to be so new, it's going to be engines that are going to win it. It's not going to be the brilliant aerodynamics, because all teams are going to have to learn. But the advantage is, if you've got your own supplier, like you build your own engines, or you're a factory team, i.e. like what Red Bull are with Renault now, it's their factory team, they get their engines before they even start building the car, which means they can build a car around the engine and vice versa. They can change engine design to fit an area of a car. Whereas all these privateer teams, like McLaren and all the others, they've got to build the car first and then make the engine fit. And see, that won't change for them until they put the Honda engine in 2015. So they've got a whole season where they're having to watch it back into the car, which a lot of teams are going to do. And that's why I think Hamilton left, because he knows, being at Mercedes, Mercedes build their own engines, they're going to have an advantage over McLaren and other teams for an entire season. And that's what I think it is. It's logic. He's done exactly what I would have done. Get the hell out of there. Because the thing is, McLaren wasn't brilliant last year. You know, a lot of the reason he left was because he was fed up with the car kept breaking down. You know, he was on for a really good in Singapore, and the car broke down, and that's when he decided to sign the contract on the Monday. And McLaren's response to it was, you should never sign a contract when you're angry. I thought, no, you've cost him four race wins this year because of your crap reliability.
Sorry.
And you had enough of it. It's, I mean, you know, it's, what did they expect he was going to do?
Yeah, well,
you get all these loyalists, he owns, you know, he owes the loyalty to McLaren. Without McLaren, he wouldn't be who he is. Yeah, without McLaren's money, he might not have made it into Formula One as quick. But McLaren have nothing to do with the driver. Lewis is good because Lewis is good, you know. That's like saying that without Renault, Alonso would have been nothing because he was at bloody, you know, Minardi. You can't say that because another big team might have taken him on and he would have won a double world championship, you know. He gave them, what, 5 or 6 years to McLaren, which I think easily paid, but he gave them a world championship. You know, what more can anyone expect of a driver than to honour him in that one?
McLaren just considered giving him a decent car.
Yeah.
I just think also last year he had like 4 or 5 DNFs, I can't remember, but just the car having issues and just breaking down, doing nothing when he was actually in the lead or on second place. And there were also many pit stop screw ups they did, forgetting wheel nuts and stuff. They made like huge mistakes, like every 2 races there was a slow pit stop or they forgot a wheel nut.
Yep.
So I think that's gonna make him happy to have some decent results and have a decent pit stop.
Yeah, as far as I'm concerned, it's what it boils down to. As a driver, you know, you got to think of other areas. And I think what he's done by going to Mercedes will improve Lewis. The thing is, it's, I mean,
I think we got a battle here. But Fisher, yeah, he was taking a defensive line, so I don't think that's just lapping traffic. Oh, he had a pull there. He did a little Lewis Hamilton back in Yas Marina Bay 2 years ago, I believe. Well, if that was a battle, it was pretty much quickly over. And yeah, no, it's not a battle.
Your wife's not there yet.
What?
Your wife's not there yet.
No, I don't know when she's coming. Probably be a little bit later. Oh, it was actually a battle for position. Buxton Fisher took over 16th place from Frank Philpson. So yeah, I thought it was just traffic, but no. Missed a battle. Well,
I don't know, we didn't. Have you spotted that car?
What car?
Don't matter. Yeah, thinking outside the box. It's now.
Well,
it's enough.
I think my frames are dropping because my laptop is overheating. I think that might be the issue instead.
What, have you got your laptop resting on?
On my... on my lap.
On your junk.
No, on my lap. Because yeah, it's warm.
On your junk?
No, on my lap.
Oh, where is your junk?
What?
Where do you keep your junk?
In my pants.
Yeah, well, there you go. You said it like Bob Marley, didn't you? Like, in my pants, man. Love it. Love it.
Well, the battle for the second position is still not over. Daniel Faber is getting closer to Sebastian Roan, so the work Rocket Ronnie did could be soon be undone. Still around 2.5 seconds gap maximum. Should be a little less. It's 2.3 seconds now. Yeah, we might see some action soon again. Also, Andrea Schmidt from Osler Racing Team has seemed to extend their lead to 28.5 seconds, so they're still going a little quicker.
Does it? For free wide, which, as I was thinking, free wide and Independence was going to have a good battle at the front. It seems All Star ain't finished this race yet.
Yeah, correct. I mean, free wide and Independence are just 2.1 second now behind each other, so it depends how much time and effort they're going to put in battling each other there, because they still have 4 hours to go. And the first man is only 28 seconds in front of second and third. And even the man on fourth place is just 17 seconds behind the third placed man. So I could easily say the top 10 isn't even lapped yet. But then I would just like... No, I wouldn't. It would just be something around... Yeah, no, it's something around that. I think the top 10-9 is not lapped yet. Yeah, there should be something right, yeah. Oh, the 10th placed man is just getting lapped, so camera 16. Let's check that. Here we go. That's Mr. Alex Piccolo. And that's not quite right. Oh, it's not Piccolo, it's Fabio Cangionali. My apologies for that. But they are going to be lapped in just a little bit of time. So we can see who's one of the top benefiters is there. But I'm guessing that's going to be Andreas Schmidt. Yep, and that might be quite alright. No, that's not the Team All Star.
The number of pit stops here.
It's only 8.
14 pit stops. Also now just got Will Graven. That's double what everyone else has done.
Well, the top 8 is lapped. We see Mr. Derek, or whatever his name was again. Brown Deck. I mean, Brown Deck, who is driving 12th position, going to get lapped. So, yep. There we go. And Sebastian Rohn just went a full second faster on the last lap. So he just pulled the gap down to 27.5 seconds. And I lost my concentration because Rohn is so determined to use the poke button.
I was just sending you a
message.
Did you read it? Mm-hmm.
I'll read it in a second. He's also pulling Daniel Faber with him on a 2:02.4. The second and third place man are still currently faster than the leader itself. So I think we will be in for a surprise. I can also imagine Tree White putting their first driver again for the last 2 hours of the stints.
You all know who that is.
Yes, that will be Marius Bertz.
Yeah.
I'm not 100% sure, but if it was me, that would be the man I would put in my car for the last final 2 hours. And especially, you know, how he was going to fly through the field at the start of the race, so he got pace. He got the overtaking skills, so it's still not over yet. Anything can change. The top 3, the top 4, if they can change, if one disconnects, he just got thrown back to the top 10.
It's certainly no fuck lady singing yet.
Massa, Felipe Massa enjoys answering his critics. Yeah, of course, because you are qualified.
Oh, there she is. Damn, she's fit.
Wayne, what are you talking about?
The little Sky Sports, I can't think of her name now.
Oh.
God's name. Oh, God, what's her name now? Talk
about that
this morning,
did
little woman.
Jesus Christ, the brain's cracked, huh? Yeah. Oh, my knees are hurting like crap.
Yeah, that's what you get for sitting on your knees last night doing, you know, what to call.
Oh, God, that's sick.
Nah. Natalie
Pinkham. And Mr. Schmidt just passed Braun Decker.
Uh-huh.
Well, just lapped him. Yeah. Not an actual overtaking pass. But yet again, Andrea Schmidt did a 2:03.2 and Sebastian did a 2:02.4. Daniel Faber is matching the pace of Sebastian Rohn, so they got a gap down to 25.4 seconds now. So they're absolutely taking bit by bit a lot of time out of the leader. So this might be a three-way battle until the end. It will be epic, very epic. I just hope Shane doesn't fall asleep or else he's gonna cry if he wakes up.
There we go. Give you the link to Natalie Pinkham. Look at that.
Hello. She looks like my girlfriend.
What? You bastard.
Yeah, just mine has bigger boobs. Shame for you, man.
Yeah, we'll have to take your word for it unless you're prepared to provide photo imaging.
Well, why does she look so muscular? I don't like that.
it's not, it's just the way it's been taken. Looks like
you no.
go for a ride if you're off me.
Nah, I don't know. Some pictures are okay. It's not all. Especially you, what's that? I don't know. Gonna throw up my feet.
Mamma mia.
Yeah, okay, Wayne, stop doing bad manners to her picture now. Be still, F. Erase, sword or less. But I don't know what happened to Daniel Faber, but he left the gap open to 4 seconds to Sebastian Rohn. So I think he made a mistake. He did a 2 minute 3.5. And Andreas Mitch. Andreas Mitch is.
What's
Felipe Massa?
Daniel Hacker's in for next factor racing 3 now as well.
Oh, I thought you said Felipe Massa.
Felipe Massa's in Formula 1 get better. He's not been factor racing this league. He
See if he gets a team radio. Sounding so far away, I can't hear you well.
My voice travels.
Yeah, say that again.
Dimitri is a faster than you.
Yeah, that will not sound too bad.
Mm-hmm.
But I wouldn't need that, I'd just overtake him.
Yeah, that's it. Well, he wouldn't make it off the start finish line before he crashed. Okay, you could easily throw out a Massa anywhere in a pit lane just for a spring. He's bound to take cover. I think Barrichello's around again. I'm getting really hot now. But I can't be asked to turn heat off.
Well, we have a battle here. Daniel Hake with Sascha Siegert in the background. Oh.
Daniel Hake.
I mean, Carsten Willem in front. I kind of overlooked myself there. So, we got both Audis R8s behind each other with two quick drivers.
They can't both be behind each other.
Oh gosh, Klaus, seriously. I need a smoke.
Well, think about it, how can they both be behind each other? It's impossible.
Don't ask me complicated questions which I can't answer.
It's a science one, it's an impossibility. Oh, I don't know. Yes. Oh, that was a bit greedy on the kerb, oh dear. Could just be about to lose position there.
Well, I think I found another battle for. Yeah, I was going to say for 13th position, but it doesn't look quite like it at the moment.
Nice, look, man.
Yeah, I'm looking the wrong guy. I don't know why, but oh my god, I didn't ask like this.
Oh, what, where we went wrong?
What the fuck? Oh, my apologies again. No, I keep pushing the camera and it just shows the other one. I want Thomas Bachi. Oh, he's in a pit. Well, that was a battle, which isn't anymore, because Thomas is in the pit.
And he's back out.
So, we are going back to the other GRXF cars.
Yep, to see if they're still behind each other.
Yep. Oh god. There we go.
Yep, they're definitely behind each other. And we're now at 4 hours remaining.
I just saw titties on television, so don't be shocked, no? Don't be hold up.
If you stick my webcam on, you're about to see a rock boom.
I'm looking at
a nice pair of titties on my television and all, Natalie Pinkham's on it.
Yep, I was just going to say that he is going to Fab Fab Land tonight.
Let alone tonight in a minute.
Okay. The race still is sticking for 4 hours.
Yeah, that don't matter. I'll mute it.
So, dear viewers who are still watching, sorry that you just left and don't want to listen to us anymore because of Wayne's bizarre. Because of Wayne's bizarre behavior, I can't really help it. I guess he's on his period.
Yeah, but everybody that's known me knows I'm just bizarre, full stop. I don't need behaviour to go with it.
Well, since he's switching too much to Natalie Pinkman.
Oh, hang on, we got a pit stop taking place, man. All-star racing team.
Oh, yeah.
I see.
There we go. Alexander Schmidt going from the lead. What will happen if he slides out and hits the wall?
you sound like an Indian joke. Yeah, I thought it was bad, but you're up here and you hear him talking with a Scottish accent and you just take him to a whole new level. Yeah, we've got...
So, Andreas Schmidt is still in third position.
Yep.
Daniel Faber just left the gap open to 6.9 seconds over Sebastian Rohn, so Sebastian is still flying. If he can keep the pace in, he could get the gap down on the next pit stop on 20 seconds.
I'm more concerned with Daniel Faber. He's going to do this, I think. I think Free Wide are going to be back in for this again.
Yeah, but he's getting slowly. I think he needs to make a stop, but he's just... I think he's trying to expand his pit stop.
Hang on a minute. All-star have done 3 stops. Sebastian and Daniel Faber have only done 8. So they're stopped doing. So hold up your horses a minute, because we're out of sync with what's going on.
Well, you are, because of Natalie.
I'm not out of sync at all. No, she's not on at the minute. It's a Curry's advert. Your camera. £449 or a washing machine for £299. It's a Lucy one. You save £170.
And this is still the closest battle with Carsten Wilhelm and Daniel Hacker.
Daniel Hacker. Sure, you're worse than Shane. You should be out of pronounce.
What did I say?
Hacker. Yeah. And
Germans pronounce it, I bet.
No, it's not. And you've had Thomas Pesch, as you call him. It's Hacker.
No, it's Hacker.
Yeah.
Daniel Hacker.
Yeah, Daniel Hacker and Thomas Packer.
Okay.
See? You should be able to pronounce these. You've got your tongue's got the lingo on it.
Nah. I was going to say something, but never mind.
It's got something else on it, more like yeah.
Yeah. You're a smart guy.
Yeah, this is obvious.
Well, I'm gonna leave this to TRL cars for you, and I'm gonna go get a fresh nose for like 5 minutes, smoke a cigarette. Mm-hmm. And somebody's
diving into pits. Oh, hang on, yeah, we got a pit stop going on. Hang on.
It's not for the lead.
Sim racing for Holland.
I saw an Audi going in also.
Yeah, hang on.
Online motorsports and fucking mineshaft.
It's freaking snowing again.
it's not sim racing for Holland. They are not in it.
No, it's snowing again. That's even worse.
Wait, what? It's snowing?
Yeah, not on the garden outside my house. So, I'm looking at the timing screen and it's right in front of the window.
It's not snowing here.
There it is here.
It's cold though.
Tell me about it. A couple of polar bears have just gone past my house.
Did you bring some cooler?
No, ain't that. They'll start doing expeditions at you before long. Sir Ranulph Hines will end up turning up at you.
Hang on,
we've got another pit stop.
Okay.
SOS KCS Falkenmoldershaw.
Yeah, already announced that. You're running behind.
Stuff up your bum then.
Okay.
I'm too busy doing weather reports.
I'm going. Okay, 5 minutes. The next pit stops will take place. Mm-hmm. As I assume Daniel Faber diving in the pits before Sebastian Roan. So, we will be back for a short break.
Yep.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm back. I don't know if I missed any pit stops. It seems that Tree White took a pit stop and Daniel Faber is still at the wheel. So Sebastian's still going and he has a 24.5 lead over second place man Andrea Schmidt. So I'm checking to see any close battles. Yeah. Carsten Willem is still carrying Daniel Hake behind him. Hake, I have to say. And, oh, we have a battle for position 12. And that is with Thomas Pacha. There we go. The Alpina just behind the Ferrari from Philippe Noël. I don't know what Swain doing, but he's probably being all over his new future girlfriend already, drooling on Sky Sports of him. I just saw the message from Shane. I've been thinking he had no lack of motivation in endurance racing. Yet, what the team is really set up for wasn't planning on doing anything else. Our history in endurance racing, Sebring 12 hours DNF, Fuji 8 hours DNF, Nürburgring 24 hours DNF. Okay, we can't do much about that one, but Daytona 24 hours DNF, Silverstone 12 hours DNF, wow. We have to thank Wayne for that. And yeah, it works. Some more blah 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 from Shane's side. But oh well. I think we can blame you for once, Wayne. Nah, but you made the call to retire the car, so wait, what, the joint? Yeah, me and your car. Oh, okay, I misunderstood that for a second.
Yeah, that's why I was gone for about 5 or 6 minutes. We worked out whether it would be worth staying, and by the time we worked out where we was relative to times, we knew we'd end up
fighting for
the last position. And it's no disrespect to the last team, because it is at all, you know, at the end of the day, like I've said, I've got no problem being last in any race if I can race someone to be there. But how we was doing, you know, we had a set up in practice that was doing 202s and 203s with three drivers, and then gets to the race and neither me nor Nico could get out the 206s, and it just, you know, you think we're going to sit there for 12 hours and achieve nothing of where we was expecting to get, you know. I mean, we're not looking for a win, we never was, and we don't complain to be that good, we can win, but we want to fight people, you know, and that's what it's all about.
Still, with only two drivers and one doing commentary and then driving, doing commentary and driving, We already know that's how hard that task already is. I mean, being commentator already is kind of a hard and stressing job, but then you have to put your concentration away for the one job and just hop in the car and be motivated and think straight forward, which isn't quite easy if you have to do stints of 2 hours. I mean, we saw Marius doing in at the start of the race doing a 3:10 if I wasn't mistaken. I could do one of an hour and a half, 2 hours maybe, but then the pace is starting to go down and I'm making mistakes. But yet some people seem to be able to keep the motivation up, to keep the concentration up and just keep pushing like they've just been driving for 5 minutes and doing hot laps. And well, for once, we're not actually seeing the GRL XF cars in the top three yet. Of course, we have still 3 hours and 26 minutes to go.
We've got Will Gray in the pit. They're disconnected. So, VE Racing as well. That's a damn pity for Will Gray. I think that's twice they've had that now. So, mate, it's taken them all the time to get back up there.
Yeah, and Flatsport Racing has just entered their 15 pit stops, which is nearly the double of what some people do, when some people are still on 8 stops. Example, Sebastian Rohn is still going on 8 stops, still leading the race of course, but the gap with All-Star Racing team Andrea Schmidt has come down to 21.5 seconds. And the gap to 3 wide is 40 seconds, so he should be comfortably ahead if it's a problemless pit stop. And then try to push and try to close the gap for the last upcoming hours. I think it's possible. Oh, Karsten just bit it. Yeah, I just noticed. Well, I just clicked Karsten and he's still going around, so I don't know what the live timing is trying to say me.
I didn't know that. Shane should have said on Facebook so I can interrupt. You've got Race Connect's closing down at the end of the year.
Oh?
Yeah.
That's a surprise.
That's news to me.
There we go. Here's Karsten. Pitting. Making one of the probably third last pit stops, maybe one more. So I'm guessing around they should be end on, well, the leaders at least on 13 pit stops, I'm guessing. Oh, and there's the beautiful Jaguar just leaving right behind Karsten, which is the only Jaguar in the race. So let's see, where did Karsten come out on position 8? So he lost 2 positions. He's only 5.5 seconds behind 7th place man Sascha Siegert, which we all know from the start for battling long but making tiny mistakes but keeping recovering. I think Sebastian Rohn is struggling big time, or he pit it. I don't know. No, he did not pit it. The time came down to 16 seconds, so he lost 5 seconds already. I'm not sure if that's quite right. But it went from 21 to 16 seconds. Of course, the gaps are not really 100% correct, but if you remove
mistake as well, or bad tyres, because he's got to be due for a pit any time now.
Yeah.
Maybe the tyres are going on all too well with these cars, where it's like sheet ice when the tyres are going.
The gap between Independence and Tree White is still 40 seconds, so yeah, All-Star Racing Team is pushing like hell. They want that win. That's very clear. As we see Karsten here unlapping himself with Andrea Schmitz. Yep. Or am I wrong? No, I'm wrong. That's the other All-Star Racing Team car. Got a little bit surprised there. go. Here's Sebastian Roan. Trying to push and maintain the gap. Ooh, he did it 2:07.5. So he went 5 seconds slower, so the life timings were right. He must have made mistakes somewhere. And it doesn't show the sector he did. But I'm guessing it should be around sector 2. That he made a little mistake or so. As Wayne is currently too busy slapping his keyboards too hard or something like that. Or he's typing with Natalie.
I'm paying attention, I'm listening to what you're saying, I'm keeping my eye on the live time, I'm just looking at the stream, but this is getting messages left on the centre at the minute.
I know, but maybe the users were thinking I was fapping or something against my mic, so
no,
I had to make it damn clear.
I'll move my microphone away.
Okay, there we go. And Sebastian pitted 2:03.2 now. Still 1 second slower than All-Star Racing Team 2, Andreas Schmidt. The gap's gone down to 15 seconds exact. So I don't know what's going on there, but they definitely need a pit stop. And they need it soon. However, it could just work out fine. They want to try to make a pit stop less, and I think that's the case they want to try to do. And if they can pull that out, one pit stop less, and they can push on the real late end, they should make a victory. But like I said, still a little less than, you know, just a little over 3 hours to go, 3 hours 19 minutes left. So anything is still possible. I said 3 hours and 19 minutes, but in fact, it's just 3 hours and 30 minutes. My clock is not correct, it appears. So, let's see if we have one more close battle. We have Carson Willem in 8, and he's like 1.5 second behind. Here we go. Sasha Seert, and this is a battle.
I don't think Will Graves coming back. They've stayed disconnected for a couple of minutes now. So I'm thinking they may have decided to call that a day.
Yeah. I'm thinking the same. Yeah, I'm
just
going to
quickly restart the server stream. We'll be right back.